Let us take this one of the most important topics which is feared by students, which is called as functions. So let me first tell you my own judgment that it is a very easy topic. What you need to understand is the meaning of functions. What are we trying to say? We are just trying to associate the variable x with the function f, and we are trying to give an answer to it. So if I say f of x is equal to x plus 10, I am just saying that whenever x comes with f, I just have to plus 10 to it to get the answer. So f of Amitabh Bachchan is nothing but Amitabh Bachchan plus 10. F of Madhuri Dixit is nothing but Madhuri Dixit plus 10. F of Gaurav Bakliwal is nothing but Gaurav Bakliwal plus 10. So f of anything in the world is anything plus 10. Please understand. Now let's say I have defined a function g of x and it is equal to x square. So g of Urmila is Urmila square. G of Sunny Leon is, I mean, don't think anything else. G of Sunny Leon is Sunny Leon square. So g of anything in the world is, by definition of g, is anything square. So what is the meaning of h function? Let's say I have defined h of x is equal to 100. So there is no x coming on the right hand side. So some students get very feared, you know, there is no x, what do we do? In fact, on the contrary, it is a very simple function. It is called as constant function. It is not dependent on x. So h of anything I put, I mean, I will always get the answer as 100. That is what is h function all about. So if I want to understand functions, I must first of all understand the basic definition, what is it trying to say. So let us take composite of function. So if I want to find what is f o g x, which is f bracket g of x. So it is nothing but f of x square, which is nothing but x square plus 10. And therefore the answer is x square plus 10, f o g x. So if I want to find what is g o f x is different from f o g x. I want to find g of f of x. So g of x plus 10, which will become x plus 10 bracket whole square. So as you can see, x square plus 10, which we got earlier, and x plus 10 whole square, which we got now, they are different numbers. So let's say I want to find one of the cat questions, f of h of f of f of g of f of x. What is the answer? So it might sound very complicated, but the answer is very simple, because h is present. And as we discussed earlier, the moment h is present, h of anything in the world is always 100 by definition of the constant function. So in other words, it question became find f of 100, and therefore answer is 100 plus 10, which is 110. So that is about meaning and composite functions. Related to it, let me also discuss, or let me also train you with a concept of odd functions and even functions. So if I have a function f of x is x square, I want to find whether it is even function or odd function. The concept is replace minus x with x. Wherever you find x, just put minus x there. So what is f of minus x? Minus x whole square, which is same as x square. So the concept is, if I get the same answer, f of minus x is exactly same as f of x. So whenever it will happen, all such functions will be even functions. So cos function is an even function, because cos of minus theta, it's actually cos theta. So what is odd function then? So again, the same concept, replace minus x with x. If I get entire minus answer, it becomes odd function. So f of x is x cube, minus of f of minus x is minus x whole cube, which is minus x cube. And therefore it becomes f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. So whenever this happens, these are odd functions. For example, f of x is equal to x, f of x is x cube, f of x is sine x, which is a very good example, because sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. So that is about the meaning and the basic of functions. My sincere recommendation is, please take this topic very sincerely. Lot of questions are asked, and it's a very easy topic at the end of the day, because everything is present out here. It is only the mental mindset that people carry that it is tough, and they leave it for preparations.